And welcome back to Let's Play Pillars of Eternity. Blind. About to open this door. See what's behind. We're in Breith Eaman. Got a locked door here and a locked door here. We've explored all the rest. Soul Guardian Pillars, Soul Adra Prison. That's the pit where he came from. And those are souls that keep reappearing every time we reload the game. Got 150 XP just for opening this door. You heard me. Fight more animat things and undead things. Hello. Theos? The door closed behind us? Or the other door opened? What's Iovara? A column of Adra rises above you, stoic and silent, its ridged layers a measuring stick for the passing of ages. It feels to you as a thick block of ice, and you perceive, buried deep in its core, a dim, flickering flame, all but extinguished, yet preserved against the ravages of the elements. At your approach, the flame seems to steady and draw strength, and the layers separating it from you melt away, and you are bathed in its glow. A bright beacon in the gloom. The glow seems to fade as though you had adjusted to its intensity, and where it was, Iovara seeps into existence, an idyllic shade hovering above the moist prison floor. Though ageless, she appears somehow different to you now, a slight stoop to her carriage, perhaps, or a trace of sunkenness in her eyes. There's a broad scar across her face, fibrous and wormy where flames once lapped, unhealed even in death.
My old pupil, you are a welcome sight, but a worrying one as well. Do you still wander lost in the darkness after all these many years? You are so different now from who you were then, yet much remains the same. Old troubles with a new face. What is it that has brought you here?
Okay, so we're no longer getting glimpsing memories of the past, of past conversations. This is her soul, and this is happening now. Number 4 is pretty brutal. So is 5. Should we free her? It would seem that I have unfinished business here.
I'd hoped after our last discussion you would find what you sought. Has it eluded you all this time?
We don't even know what we're looking for.
I can only guess your presence here has something to do with Theos. The energy of this place changes when he is near. I don't know what he has done, but I do know of the souls that pass through here now. They do not come by choice.
Theos diverted them from the cycle. He seeks to empower Whittaka and to blame Animancy for the damage he's caused. Yeah, that's the whole story. At least, we think so.
After all this time, he would still stand against the tide.
You knew me when Theos did. There's something I need to know about that time.
I will tell you what I remember.
She nods. There's something about that lifetime my soul can't let go of. I need to know what it is, and I'm running out of time. I see moments from that life. Of you, of the Inquisition, of Theos.
I can see his influence, still hanging like a weight about your neck. So it always was. He had inspired something in you. We spoke of him the last time you were here also. It was just after the trial. You were agitated. I think because you started to consider that what I was teaching may have been true.
And what was that? Iovara's mouth tightens, and her brow furrows, a look of pity. Her eyes shift back and forth between each of yours, as if looking for something that would help her decide whether to speak.
That the gods aren't real.
What? The gods aren't real. Pellegrino throws her head back and laughs gleefully. Ha ha ha! Of course not! It all makes sense now. Is she being sarcastic?
I'd dreaded the idea from the moment the Delamgon suggested it. And yet, it almost feels like a relief.
Then who the hell are we talking to in the Chamber of the Stars, or whatever the hell it's called?
She's not serious.
Perhaps not to her. Many are those whom the gods have scorned. This is petty retribution.
But that's not... Is that the truth we've come for? That even the gods are false?
Kanna gazes at Iovara, expression unreadable.
What I taught was that the gods whose faith we had been spreading were not gods at all, but something else entirely. Something created by people.
Who created these gods? And for what?
They were conceived by Enguith, a society of high minds and broad concerns. Theos's people. In their time, every people worshipped its own gods. Sometimes they warred over it. After a few wars of their own, the Enguithans sought an end to it. They devoted all their energy to finding the true creators. Generation after generation, they prodded and worked the stitching of the world and unlocked its secrets. One day, they found an answer. Except the answer was no answer at all. There were no gods to be found. Or if there ever were, they were gone.
Then who the hell did we talk to in that chamber?
It shook them, this finding. If they could discover this on their own, how long until others would? How long before war and chaos reigned over a world without consequence? But they had mastered many things in their pursuit of these answers. And with their mastery, they crafted their own gods to fill the void, and sent missionaries to the corners of the world to spread their faith.
How did you discover this?
The Enguithan missionaries all knew it, but they never told the rest of us. They meant it to be a secret that died with them. And in the end, they allowed their bloodlines to fade from memory. I had been assigned to join a few of them at a temple. I found the door to their chambers closed, but the room was stone and the door thin. Their voices carried. I heard... enough. I investigated the things they spoke of, and everything was there, just as they said it'd be.
Later on, after I left the Order, a few Enguithans found my words persuasive and joined my cause. They revealed what I did not already know. So are those Enguithans we were talking to? Using, I guess, magic? To communicate? Is this why you started your own faith?
I never thought of it as faith, but I think you are right to call it that. Let the world see. Let them decide what to do. That was my faith. I became a missionary because the gods brought me hope that I wanted to bring to others. For a time, the truth sent me to a dark place. Then the day came when I realized nothing had changed. That I still had a purpose, and the purpose was the same and it was worth living for. I began questioning the other missionaries in public, exposing their parlor tricks. In time, their following became mine.
Is it true, what you taught?
You asked me this once before. Nothing I can say would be any proof, and it may be certainty your soul craves. Resolution. But if you are bound for the same place Theos directs these souls, you will see for yourself as you once did. Everyone faces this truth at one time or another. Few confront it. Few have the stomach to ask what if. And in avoiding the question, they deny themselves an identity of their own.
Iovara scans her audience in silence, her eyes thoughtful, lingering on each member of your company in turn, finding interest in things unseen.
What if all the tragedy, all the persecution, came in defense of an imposter?
She looks to Adair when she says that.
That's not... That can't be right. Aethys, he's done miracles for people.
The power of the gods is undeniable. The truth of the story they weave is not. What if it were forbidden knowledge rather than fault that earned your doom? What of your guilt?
She turns her attention to Durrance.
I have seen with my own eyes the deceptions of my goddess. The Watcher has shown me as much. But it was not until now that I understood how truly desperate she was. The depths of her deception.
You speak of her deceptions, but what of your own? Was it her words that led you down your path? Or was it the absence of her words? A gap that you filled with your own broken thoughts.
Beads of sweat coalesce on Durrance's forehead and trickle down the sides of his face in streaming rivulets, as though he were a block of ice standing before a great pyre. Good analogy.
What if you had always been alone, without guidance?
Her eyes settle on Aeloth.
Well, as poorly as I've chosen my guides, I suppose it would be a comfort to know that I'm free of them.
Aeloth folds his hands behind his back, furrowing his brow.
The freedom has always been. It was the guidance that was the illusion. If all our common threads are spun from a lie, what's left to bind us together?
She looks up at Kanarua.
I don't know. I never found the answers I sought. But after all we have seen, I think the gods are not enough. Perhaps the threads are unraveling. The lie is too old. I think maybe we are all meant to be divided. Every effort, every search for a single truth will end in failure. Because there is no single truth. We seek simple answers where there are none.
Threads spun from falsehoods tend to unravel on their own, my friend. For it is in our natures to seek truth. What if even mastery over all things cannot answer the most basic of questions?
She considers Palagina.
I stopped asking those questions long ago. It is enough to care for those we love with the time we have in this life.
You feel the weight of Iovara's translucent eyes upon your soul. What if we can be assured of nothing? Got a lot of options here. The only value is in the things we create ourselves. We had best build our own strength so we can bear it. Only when we cease to exist as beings can peace be found. It's the questions that have always posed more value than their answers. Good point. The fewer people who realize that, the better. Then all we can do is endure, or I don't know. Deliberating. One or two... I sense 4 and 5 are leading us to just let them know that, just let them keep believing that those are their gods. I mean, could be necessary. I don't want to lead it that way right now. I want to see what happens. Then the only value is in the things we create ourselves. I often just end up choosing the first option.
Verus. We find purpose in ourselves and in the people in our lives.
Palagina nods in approval.
There is bliss to be found in the things we create, but sorrow as well. Every creation bears the imperfections of its creator, and its creator's creator. Art and song are creations, but so are weapons and lies. We must be careful that our creations do not consume us. I ask these things not to trouble you, but to show why they must be confronted. No answer is simple, but somewhere between them all lies a truth so beautiful, not even a god could conceive it. Do we not owe ourselves a chance to find our part in it?
Part in what? In part of the truth? That is so beautiful, not even a god can conceive it? Find our part in it. Yeah. We do. Even without assurances, there is still truth.
If that is truly what you believe, then you are a far different person than the one I knew.
I don't know who the hell you knew, other than it was me, or some variation of me.
I've been alone here with my thoughts for so long now. I've found peace with my failures, and with my punishment. I no longer curse fate for what might have been. But there is one thing that has clawed and scraped at my mind all these years. One thing that will not be put to rest until I know. Until I understand.
Do I know the answer to this thing? For the first time, hints of doubt trace her serene visage.
I need to know why you chose to remain with the Inquisition, even after you'd learned the truth. Do you remember?
As she asked, the memory springs to your mind immediately, as though it had just happened. Now, I don't think the game ever tells us, or the story ever tells us, so we're making the past at this point. We are forming the past with these answers, just like before, when we decided who she was. She could have been a former lover, is what we chose, but we chose that she was our mentor. After the Inquisition, I remained even though I knew the truth. Why would I do such a thing? Your teachings were a threat to all I believed in. I resented you. I wanted to please the gods. Your capture brought me glory. I was afraid of what Theos might do to me if I didn't agree to it. I don't think I had a reason. I just did it. Sorry there are no assurances. I don't know. Do we really hate her so much? Do we really despise her and her teachings, which is most of these answers? I wanted to please the gods? I'm afraid of what Theos might do. No reason. Is this kind of like, I don't know, I don't remember? Sorry, there are no assurances. Yeah, I don't even know. Sorry, there are no assurances. Iovara looks at you with the face of one condemned. Her mouth moves, but she speaks no words. Her eyes glaze, focus no longer on you, but on some invisible, crushing vision before her. I don't know, guys. I don't even know what I answered, how I answered. Did my opinion matter so much to you?
You were a blank slate to me once. A blank slate that I had taught the wrong things. I'd given you a false faith. I had to know I could undo what I had done. Redirect you to embrace the truth. You had heard both sides, seen everything. If not you, then who?
Optimism misplaced. I see your point. I see your point.
I'm aware of the folly of trying to learn so much from so little. I've had time to consider that in all its facets. But in the end, it was all I had. You denied me a chance to know your reasons. And even if you hadn't, some part of me would always know it didn't truly answer what I wished to know. Nor will an eternity of silent contemplation. I will have only my guesses and suspicions. And that will have to do.
Jeez, now I feel sorry that I didn't give her a reason. Even though most of those reasons were bad. I would have felt sorry for telling her any of that, I don't know.
And what of your understanding of our past? Are you at ease with the choice you made?
I see the world differently now than I once did. I regret what I did to you and wish your forgiveness.
There is nothing to forgive. The fault was always mine. I led you down the path that led to Theos. When I tried to steer you back, it was too late. To have taught someone wrong is far worse than to have done wrong yourself. Long have I wished to make amends for this, but the time has long since passed. At first I thought this might be the source of your soul's anguish, but now I see I was mistaken. You are not divided on this matter. You have put it behind you. It is with Theos that your agony lies, in sun and shadow. Your questions are not for me, but for him. And it may be that only an answer from the mouth of Theos himself will satisfy your needs.
I was afraid clicking continue here would interrupt her. We are granted steps to the wheel. Steps to the wheel.
Yet if there is anything I can tell you that would be of use, ask and you shall know.
Yeah, basically everything. This place, Sun and Shadow, what is it? I could tell you what I believe, but again, it would be no proof. I have only what I have seen and what others have told me about it. There is only one man who can tell you now, who knows it to a certainty, and you shall face him soon enough. I will leave you to see it for yourself, make your own judgments. Better for your soul that way, I think. Do you know what it is I need from Theos?
I could not say for sure. But you have been to Sun and Shadow before.
I have?
And it came at a crossroads in your life, when much of what you knew had been upended. I have to believe it will come to you there. Your concerns then were of loyalty and trust and the gods. Everything I told you seemed to send you further into doubt. His words mattered to you when you knew him then. After you and I spoke, you went immediately to seek him out. Perhaps you simply sought confirmation from the man you trusted. If something from that time still troubles you, it may be something he told you then, or refused to tell you. He keeps secrets better than any in this world.
Why has Theos done all this?
He cares only for the secret he keeps locked away. He destroys anyone who might discover it, no matter their chances. That's why he's always favored Woodica. It isn't in her love of promises or justice. It's her disregard for the rules. Her willingness to do what is necessary. To Theos, she's not a deity, but an ally with which to conspire. When her power waxes, she does as she pleases with this realm, as well as hers. And she wants that secret guarded as much as he.
I want to find out who these so-called gods are that we spoke to. They're not gods, they're fake, so who's Woodica? Really? Who's Galloween? Who's Helia? Are they just people who are communicating with us? Magically, like I was thinking?
If Theos succeeds, there will be a shift in the balance of power among the gods. Whitaker was vanquished once when the other gods decided she had gone too far and her power diminished. With this infusion, there is no telling what she will do. The only certainty is that there will be chaos in their realm, as well as ours.
How can I get Theos to tell me what I need to know?
You will not find a more resolute being on all of Iovara. There is no offer you could make, nor spell you could cast, nor pain you could inflict that would make him reveal what he hides. But I see you have become a watcher in this life. Perhaps in defeat, when he can no longer defend himself, you might learn something from him.
In defeat, when he can no longer defend himself. Are you bound here until the end of time?
In a matter of speaking. This is Breith Eaman, the court of the penitents.
Knew I said it wrong.
Souls are confined here until they repent. They must beg the forgiveness of a god, pledge their soul to them, and they will be lifted from this place to the world above. In truth, they receive leniency, but not true mercy. The spite of Whitaker is eternal. They linger above, at the side of the old court, and are not permitted to leave the island, forever severed from the cycle. This prison was full once in the days of the Inquisition, but time weathers all things, even will. I'm the only tenant who remains. Yet, I feel their presence strongly now, as it was in the beginning. You have brought many of them here. They cry out for the judgment of Theos. You have struck some bargain with the gods, then.
They're not gods, remember? Why are you calling them that? The other gods aid me because they want Theos destroyed. I owe them no debt, other than to carry out what they want me to do.
They aid you because they would bend you to their own purposes. Engwith built gods from ideals, and an ideal on its own is a grotesque and vicious thing.
So what are you going to do with these souls, then?
But these souls... These forgiven the gods have bequeathed you like chattel.
She heard me.
They were loyal followers in life. They will be with you to the very end.
Why don't you repent? You could be free of this place.
Last time someone asked me that, I was bound to an iron wheel with a broken spine.
Ouch.
There are many things I've come to doubt about the choices I made in life. But that trial was my one moment of certainty. Even without a chorus of gods to tell me I had been right. The gods need to be reminded that we have a spirit, and that spirit is proof against their power. They have the power to manipulate, and confuse, and ruin us, but not to change our will. I will remain here until the world crumbles and fades from existence, with joy in my heart, knowing I've shown them what they truly are.
How is it that you speak Adirin? I speak no language now, but the wordless expressions of the spirit. It is through my connection to you that I am able to draw upon your words and form them as my own. All right. It's time for me to go.
Theos will not wait for you. If you do not catch up to him now, you may never find him again.
Reading... Yeah. The gods have given me the souls of their forgiven. If you repent, you could join with them. Help me strike the final blow against Theos.
If I repent, all I have done has meant nothing.
But your defiance here is an illusion. You are a slave to the gods, bound to their rules, stuck in their system. Your continued existence is proof of the gods' dominion over all of us. You notice a bond now, one that has always been, an interleaving of her essence with yours at the extremities of your perception. You are tied to this woman's spirit, and you could feel a measure of control over it, as though you were its shepherd. She says, "What are you suggesting?" Wait. If we disintegrate her soul, how would she help us? well, which makes me kind of not want to do it because I'm disintegrating her soul, but would that be preferable to leading life just until the end of time here? In the end, it's her choice, but then again, I do have a measure of control over her soul. I don't want to force her into it. Is it harm just to ask? I can disintegrate your soul, make you cease to exist. Then I would be no different than the other souls the gods have broken in this place. I do not wish to stop fighting them. Well, we don't have any of the 18 scores, 18 levels or whatever of resolve, perception, or intellect, so I will respect your wishes.
For my part in leading you to Theos in the very beginning, I hope you can forgive me.
I do.
I hope whatever final guidance I've given you here proves more useful. If ever we should meet again, in this life or any other, I hope to find you at peace.
Thank you. I actually wish the same for you. Well, that was interesting. Pillar tugging at essence again. Continue that way. Let's search around.
Lay low.
That was a long... that was a very long conversation. Now this is that other door. We've been that way. Day 31 copper. Well, our destination lies this way. Thanks for watching. See you in the next episode. And don't forget, endure. In enduring, grow strong.